पढ़ रहे थे और हमारे कुलूब को हुजूर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के जज्ब मोहब्बत से गरमा रहे थे। इमाम अहमद कॉन्फ्रेंस की दूसरी निशस्त का आगाज जनाब राशिद हसन कादरी साहब के मकाले से होगा। जनाब राशिद हसन कादरी साहब प्रोफेसर हामिद हसन कादरी मरहूम मखूर के साहबजादे हैं और हबीब बैंक में सीनियर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट हैं, हबीब बैंक की ट्रेनिंग डिवीजन के चीफ हैं। मैंने इमाम अहमदज़ा अलैह रहमत की सातवीं जिल्द जो मामलात पर है, फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजैक्शंस पर है, जिसमें मुशारका मुदारबा को डील किया गया है, वो मैंने इनको पेश की थी पिछले साल। वो पाकिस्तान में पहली बार हमने छपाई थी मदीना पब्लिशिंग से, वो मैंने इनको मुताले के लिए दी थी। राशिद हसन कादरी साहब ने उससे मुतासिर होके ये बहुत मुख्तसर मकाला लिखा है और इन्होंने बैंकर की और फाइनेंशियल एक्सपर्ट्स की हैसियत से जो चीजें उसमें देखी हैं वो आप तक पहुंचाई हैं। मैं उनसे दरख्वास्त गुजार हूं कि वो तशरीफ लाएं और अपने तजर्बे से जो कुछ भी उन्होंने उसमें पढ़ा है और हासिल किया है सामीन को मुस्तफीद फरमाएं। जनाब हकीम सईद साहब तशरीफ लाए हैं, मैं उनको खुश आमदेद कहता हूँ, उनसे दरख्वास्त करता हूँ कि ऊपर तशरीफ लाए। एक बात अर्ज करता हूँ कि ये मकाला अंग्रेजी में लिखा गया है, लेकिन ये अंग्रेजी बहुत आसान जबान इसमें इस्तेमाल की गई है, सामीन का खास ख्याल रखा है। मैं उन लोगों से माजरत खा हूँ जो अंग्रेजी नहीं समझ पाएंगे, इसलिए कि हमने सोचा था कि इसका उर्दू तर्जुमा पेश किया जाए, लेकिन मसरूफियात इस कॉन्फ्रेंस की तैयारी की इतनी थी कि ये काम हमसे ना हो सका। मैं माजरत खा हूँ।
The title of my paper is A Forgotten Omniscient. A servant, an omniscient of his caliber is difficult to match. One is surprised and left only to praise Allah Almighty. When one learns that Ala Hazrat had completed his academic curriculum when he was just 13 years, 10 months and 5 days of age. He himself had admitted and counted that he was authority in 59 different subjects. He counted and referred to these subjects in the notation made in the certificate of authority, Sanad-e-Ijazat, issued to the learned people of Makkah Mukarrama. The certificate of authority is issued by the one who himself has been acknowledged as authority, and he through the certificate authorizes the one declared to be competent in the subjects referred to in the certificate. It is not like the present day degrees. It is issued only when one has been tested and considered to be eligible for the honor. In the certificate, Hazrat Ahmad Raza Rahmatullah Alayh has declared that 21 subjects he has learned from his father and 38 subjects he has mastered without any guidance and teaching from any teacher or mentor. The incidence of Dr. Ziauddin is known to everybody. Dr. Ziauddin, a world-class authority in mathematics, when wanted to go to Germany to solve a problem, was advised to consult Ala Hazrat. Reluctantly, he visited Bareilly and was astounded to get the problem solved in no time. Another equally surprising event was when at the beginning of Ramzanul Mubarak, someone informed Ala Hazrat that a suitable Hafiz-e-Quran one who has memorized the whole Quran and leads the Taraweeh special prayer in Ramadan was not available. Ala Hazrat, with all humbleness, promised to lead the prayers, though he had not memorized the Quran and was not expected to lead the prayers. It is said that during the day he used to memorize and in the night repeat the chapters with all recognized rules for reciting the Holy Quran. It was only God-gifted. His exegetical skills make him distinct from others who have translated and interpreted Quran. To quote one example, we reproduce one verse from Maarif-e-Raza, 1988, volume 8, page 35. I quote, وَوَجَدَكَ دَعَلًا فَهَدَى. Number one translation, did he not find you wandering and guide you? An English translation published in Beirut. Two, and he found thee wandering and he gave the guidance. Abdullah Yusuf Ali. Three, and found thee lost on the way and guided thee. Muhammad Asad. Four, and he found thee wandering in search for him and guided thee unto himself. Maulvi Sher Ali Qadiani. Five, and he found thee wandering, so he guided thee, Abdul Majid Daryabad. Six, and found thee grouping, Maulana Muhammad Ali Lahori Qadiani. Seven, and he found you uninformed of Islamic laws, and he told you the way of Islamic laws, Maulana Ashraf Ali Thana. Eight, did he not find thee erring and guide thee, Atbari? Nine, did he not find thee wandering and direct thee, Pikthar? Ten, and saw thee unaware of thy way, so showed you straight way, Maulana Fateh Muhammad Alandhari. 11, and he found you drowned in his love, therefore gave way unto him, Maulana Ahmad Raza Khan. Unquote. The Arabic word dal has many different meanings, and in terms of literature is correct, but all the 10 translators were devoid of love, devotion, respect and reverence to Sarkare Do Alam Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And while translating for God that Hadith-e-Mubarak, where it has been declared that one cannot be a true follower unless one loves and respects Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam above everything. One cannot think even a word with the flair of minutest disrespect. Hazrat Ahmad Raza used the meaning which was appropriate to the occasion. He did not coin the meaning. It was there, but only a mu'min could use it. His brilliance, talent, God-gifted ability, skill, and intelligence were neither recognized in his time nor acknowledged properly after him. He was painted as orthodox and biased person. An interesting and eye-opener admission comes from a learned man of Deoband, Maulvi Siraj Ahmad, who acknowledged that we were forbidden to read the books authored by Maulvi Ahmad Raza, saying that they were not the research work and were not worth reading. I wanted to solve a problem regarding inheritance and was not satisfied with the replies from the learned ones of Deoband, Delhi, and Saharanpur. I also referred to Maulvi Ahmad Raza Khan. The reply received from him helped me in understanding the problem and its solution. I got other books written by him, and they changed me altogether and corrected my notions. Stubborn attitude of his contemporaries is evident from another incident. A number of persons before him and after translated the Quran, but none could translate the very first verse in the Holy Quran as beautifully as Ala Hazrat did. Everyone has translated Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim as Shuru karta hoon Allah ke naam se jo bada meherban aur rahm karne wala. But Ala Hazrat did the magic when he translated as Allah ke naam se Shuru jo nihayat meherban aur rahm wala. So that when one recites, he in fact starts in the name of Allah. But please note the attitude that the others should have welcomed, appreciated, and adopted the translation in later editions, but they didn't. To our knowledge, only one translator in recent years, Peer Karam Ali Shah Sahab, has adopted the translation in his Ziaul Quran. Ala Hazrat is, we believe, one of those learned people who have been referred to in Hadith-e-Mubarak, Ulama-e Ummati ka Anbiya-e Bani Israel. The learned people among my followers are like messengers sent to people of Israel. Economics is also a subject he has deliberated upon. The economical guideline he proposed in 1912 are in fact charter for Muslims, and had the Muslim leaders and businessmen at that time adopted these, it would have been a different story. He proposed the following 3-point guidelines. Number one, the Muslims should settle their conflicts by mutual consultation so that crores which are squandered in unnecessary litigation may be saved. Number two, the rich Muslims of Bombay, Calcutta, Rangoon, Madras, and Hyderabad should set up banks for their Muslim brethren. Number three, the Muslim should not purchase anything from non-Muslims. They should have business dealing with Muslims only. The far-reaching impact on economical life of Muslims may be imagined. The Muslim leaders and businessmen realized very late, when Khwaja Nazimuddin established Muslim Chamber of Commerce and Habib family at Bombay established Habib Bank in 1941. Ala Hazrat in his Fatawa-e Razviya, in replies to questions, has dealt money matters, business transactions, commercial contracts thoroughly and in simple language, supported by thorough reasoning and references to Quran, Ahadith-e-Mubarakah, and other authorities. In 1977, Council of Islamic Ideology was established to evolve methodology to introduce non-interest-based system in banking and financing. In our opinion, it was right time to consult the books and fatwas of Ala Hazrat. Had it been done with open mind and thorough understanding, the task would have been much easier. The passage of Mudaba Ordinance also made the system more complicated. His fatwa on currency notes is revolutionary one, an unique example of his exegetical skill. He has dealt with minute details of every aspect of currency notes, covering 72 pages from 126 to 197 in volume 7 of Fatawa-e Razviya. In short, Ala Hazrat has declared that currency notes are commodity like any other commodity and may be transacted for a price more or less than the value printed on it. Had this fatwa been discussed in depth by the Council of Islamic Ideology, it would have presented convenient method for short-term financing. The fatwas and discussions of Ala Hazrat are worth reading, and we wanted to present most of them which relate to economic activities, mortgages, transfer of property, and other aspects. However, we give some of his fatwas in connection with commercial transactions and money matters to support our stand that had these been given due understanding, it would have been a very easy and convenient task to transform the economy in terms of Islamic values. We acknowledge and admit for any mistake in translating the theme of these fatwas. Problem number one. One person wants to take loan of rupees 100 and the other person wants to give the loan. How it should be documented, and also the lender does not want to give loan without an extra amount. Solution. That is the fatwa. An easy solution is as under. The payer should not give a loan. Instead, he should sell the note. For example, the person who wants 100 rupees to be repaid in 1 year and the payer wants some profit on it, the payer should sell 100 rupee note for say rupees 112 to be repaid in 1 year. If the purchaser repays in 6 months, then the seller should accept only 106 rupees. In the alternate, the payer should give a loan of rupees 100 and the debtor should give some of his movable property for safekeeping to the creditor and say that for safekeeping he would pay say 1 rupee per month. Fatawa-e Rizviya, volume 7, page 121. Problem 2. Zaid wants to take 150 rupees from Amru, a loan free of interest, and Amru wants to earn some profit on it, which should not be interest. How the transaction may take place? Solution. An easy solution is as under. Zaid, who wants loan, should sell something such as utensils or cloth to Amru for rupees 150. Amru should purchase and pay rupees 150 to Zaid. Either in the same sitting or some other time, Amru may resell the same item for rupees 200 to Zaid to be paid in 1 year. Zaid should purchase it. Now for the repayment, may mortgage the same commodity to Amru if they agree, or Zaid would get his commodity back and owe rupees 200 to Amru. Amru should not use the commodity if it is left in mortgage. Fatawa-e Rizviya, volume 7, page 121. Problem 3. Zaid told Amru, you purchase the goods worth 1 rupee and I will purchase from you for 1 rupee and 1 anna, but will pay after 1 month as I do not have money. Is this excess permissible? Solution. Permissible, but if the intention of adding 1 anna is because it is a debt, then it is not correct. It means that it should be a transaction of sale and purchase, not of a loan. Fatawa-e Rizviya, volume 7, page 57. Problem 6. Here three situations have been referred. One situation, Zaid said to Amru, Bakr owes me money, you should recover and keep with you and use it. And I would take whenever I am in need. Second situation, Zaid sold 1,000 rupees note for rupees 1,200 for 4 months to Amru and got his undertaking in writing. Then Zaid purchased 1,100 rupees note for rupees 1,200 from Bakr and for his satisfaction gave the undertaking of Amru to Bakr and told him to recover from Amru. Number three situation, Zaid sold 1,000 rupees note for 1,100 rupees to Amru and on the condition that 100 rupees should be paid in cash immediately and the balance of 1,000 after the expiry of the period and also got undertaking by Amru in writing. Then Zaid purchased from Bakr 1,000 rupees note for rupees 1,050 and paid rupees 50 immediately and gave the undertaking of Amru to Bakr. Now the question is that are all these three transactions permissible? Allah Hazrat has given only one word in reply that all the three transactions are permissible. But my note is that it may be noted that how simply the modern concept of negotiation and negotiable instrument has been dealt. Fatawa-e-Razviya, Volume 7, page 288. Problem 5 and the last. Camp Meerut Bazar Lal Kurti from Mr. Abdul Samad. I seek your opinion in the matter that we pay the amount to poor people to some 2 rupees, it was 1871. And to some 3 rupees are paid. 4 or 5 persons told me that for 2 rupees, we have to travel from our places to Meerut, and equal amount is spent on fare. Therefore, the amount may be sent through money order. After consideration, I thought that the fee for money order is the payment for the service as the post office makes the payment to the addressee and returns the receipt to me. Thus, the payment through money order was being done for years. Now, Mr. Rashid Ahmad Gangohi has declared that the fee for money order is interest and therefore forbidden. Please guide us. Solution. I have seen that fatwa of Mr. Rashid Ahmad Gangohi, where he has declared that these 2 anas, money order fees, is interest. But this can be declared only by a person who does not know the purpose of this payment. Perhaps he does not know that the post office is the shop of a common vendor. Allah Hazrat has used the word ajire mustarak, which has been opened for the recovery of charges for the services rendered. These 2 anas are only charges for taking the money to the recipient and bringing the receipt back, as the charges are paid on envelopes and parcels. This is in fact not the payment of interest. We have abridged the text. The detail may be seen in Fatawa Volume 11 from page 26 to page 40, where the references from 30 books have been given. And remarkable point is that the reply was written from a village where Allah Hazrat had gone for 4 months. And he requested Mr. Abdul Sami to send its receipt at Bareilly's address. How these 30 books were referred, it is the point to ponder. Thank you very much.